Hi children, how are you all doing? This is Vijaya, Secondary English Language Faculty from Vignan School ECIL. I welcome you all for the video listen sessions. Today we are going to start the first lesson of your new class, that is class 9. Are you all interested? Maybe yes. Maybe I guess that you are all having a smile on your face to have the first session of your video lesson. Today's first lesson, before I start, I just give you an interactive session to just listen to and respond to yourself being at home. If at all you are given a chance to board into a time machine which can take you to your far future, what sort of changes would you usually imagine to be? Any guesses, children? Have you all seen time machine, maybe in cinemas, which takes us to our past sometimes, it takes us even to our future? Many things, yes? Yeah. Here we have a lesson, the same kind, which is all about the year 2157. Isn't it something very wonderful and interesting as well? Shall we all get into the lesson now? Yes, I believe all of you are ready with your ebooks of NCERT class 9. So today we are here with the first lesson, The Fun They Had. You all can please see and look at the board as well. The Fun They Had, and written by Isaac Asimov, and it has only two characters. One is Margie, another one is Tommy. Children, don't misunderstand the name of Tommy as soon as you hear. It's not a name of an animal, but it's a name of a boy. Shall we all go ahead with the lesson, children? Here we go. Margie even wrote about it that night in her diary on the page headed 17th May 2157. She wrote, "Today Tommy found a real book." So this is an extract taken by the diary entry of Margie, which she has written on 17th May of 2157. I know most of you might be already calculating how many years ahead this lesson is all about. Keep doing it, but not now. After the lesson, once I finish the session, you all can please be busy with your calculations. So this lesson is an extract, as I said, taken from Margie's diary entry, which was made on 17th of May 2157. And she started her entry saying that Tommy found a book, which is a real book. It was a very old book. Margie's grandfather once said that when he was a little boy, his grandfather told him that there was a time when all stories were printed on paper. She's wondering, children, if at all you observe the way she's exclaiming here, she's wondering to see that Tommy mentioned her, that Tommy's grandfather mentioned that his father stated that they used to have books where the printing used to be taking place on the papers. She's wondering, because which year are they speaking about? In 2157. So maybe in 2157, they may not use the books. So now, children, here we go with another quick activity. As I said that if at all you are given a chance to board into a time machine and go into your future, and what would you see? There is a picture given in your NCERT textbook. You all please can just look at the picture. Can you all see the picture? Can you all see? Yes. These are the different ways of learning. Maybe you all can just imagine and think or assume in the year 2100 plus years. In the first picture, you can see a boy sitting in front of the system and learning something, like maybe you're all doing it. And then virtual classroom, where it's nothing but an online. You can see me, but I cannot see you. So this is not online, this is only video session. Another one is a robotic teacher. So instead of having a human teacher, human being, there is a robot which teaches the lessons to the students. Then another one is moving. E-text is nothing but an e-book. So these are the four methods which are already been shown in your book. Is everybody clear? So let's move on to the lesson. They turned the pages, which were yellow and crinkly, and it was awfully funny to read words that stood still instead of moving the way they were supposed to on a screen, you know. So they turned the pages. Who turned the pages? As I said, there are only two characters in the lesson. That is, one is Margie, another one is Tommy. Margie is 11 years old girl and Tommy is 13 years old boy. So both of them, what did they do? They mentioned the color of the book as yellow. Why is it yellow in color? Maybe as it is very old, it has turned its white color into yellow. And they also used another word to describe the book's status as crinkly. What does it mean by crinkly? Crinkly is having many folds in it. Sometimes, you know, the book, when it has been several times used and when it becomes so old, when it is not taken good, proper care, then you see the crinkly. There are folds on the paper. So such kind of a book they found, and they started looking it, and Margie was wondering, how come the people used to read the letters with the help of the book where the letters are standing still? Now children, I just give you an example. You all might be watching the television news, right? So just below that you will see even the news, other items, advertisements scrolling down. They keep moving. As the letters are, and the words, they keep moving, even your eyeball keeps moving, and that's how you read. So they are such sort of children who are used to that technology. Now Margie is finding it so interesting and wonderful, and she is even wondering, how come the people used to read the letters standing still, that too on the paper, whereas they never move, you know. She is exclaiming that, whether Tommy understands or not. And then, when they turned back to the page before, it had the same words on it that it had when they read it for the first time. So, when they had turned back to the page before, they could see the same page. For example, you might not understand as I just read it now. I'll just show you practically. For example, I'm just teaching this page 1 and you all can see. Once I complete this, automatically I shall be turning to page 2, right? So now what is Margie wondering all about, you know? As she is turning back to the same page, the back page, the previous page, she is able to see the same matter. That is what is making Margie to have lot of amazement. She is wondering, oh, how come? Because they are all habituated to have the electronic print, but not this one. Because once the letters and words, once they read, they disappear as soon as they go to the next page. Until they click on to the previous page, they will not be able to see. So that's what they were wondering. Oh my God, how come the same print, same matter is still existing when they turn back the page? They are just wondering. Then Tommy exclaims, saying, gee, he says, gee, what a waste. When you are through with the book, you just throw it away, I guess. Our television screen must have had a million books on it, and it's good for plenty more. I wouldn't throw it away. Then Tommy calls the book as waste, because he says, once the reading is done, what for the book is kept? So we should immediately throw it away. Then it's a waste. So whatever the effort is taken to get the book printed seems to be a waste for Tommy. Because they belong to the generation of which year, children? You should never forget. They belong to the year 2157. Same with mine, said Margie. Even Margie says, yeah, even I think the same way. She was 11 and hadn't seen as many telebooks as Tommy had. Because Tommy is older to whom? It is Margie. Because he was 13 years old. She said, where did you find it? Then Margie started inquiring, talking to Tommy, saying, where did you find this book? In my house, he pointed without looking, because he was busy reading in the attic, he said. So he did not show where did he find the book, but he just started looking only at the book. He said he found the book in the attic. What do you mean by attic, children? Attic is nothing but a space just below the roof used as a storeroom, as a loft, you know, unused or rarely used things and all. No, we keep them very properly, safely, we put them there, and whenever we want to use it, we just bring them down, use it and again put it back. That's called a loft. That's nothing but an attic mentioned here. What is it about? So what is that book about? Who is questioning here? It is Margy questioning Tommy. That what is that book all about? That book is all about the school. Margy was scornful. School? What's there right about school? I hate school. So scornful, there is another word, children. Scornful means nothing but showing you think something is worthless. So in Margie's point of view, according to Margie's opinion, Margie thinks that school is a waste of time. It's unworthy to go to school because they belong to 2157. You please never forget that. Then she comments, oh, I hate school. Then Margie always hated school. But now she hated it more than ever. The mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography, and she had been doing worse and worse until her mother had shaken her head sorrowfully and sent for the country inspector. So here they have given us the reason. They started saying the lesson, you know, where Margy commented that no, it's unworthy school, I hate school. So there should be a reason behind stating something. So what could be the reason? What made Margy to say so, that she was hating the school? It was nothing about the mechanical teacher which teaches her in 2157 years. So there is a mechanical teacher, children, try to imagine. So mechanical teacher is nothing but a machine which teaches the young child here, Margy. And what does it give her? The work is nothing but taking a test day by day, everyday tests. Do you like to write tests every day, children? Definitely not. But you are happy to write acid test once in at least a fortnight. But daily conducting written tests, you know, where you are assessed, you are given, you are rated by teachers, so you hate sometimes. So same thing happened with Margy as well, as she did not want to write the test, but she cannot do anything because it was the mechanical teacher to conduct daily tests there. And always she used to write the tests in geography, that is your social sciences, right? And whereas her score used to be very low, as she had no interest, if one has no interest in one particular subject, of course it automatically it reflects in the score as well. So even Margy's score used to be very low, due to which her mom used to be always sorrowful. She used to be very sad, and by looking at her own mother, even Margy used to feel very sorry. And she was often sent to the country inspector. Country inspector is nothing but the one who inspects the IQ levels, intelligent quotient levels of the children. Then he was a round little man. See, children, in the fourth paragraph, Margy is describing her country inspector. How was the inspector? The one who used to test her IQ levels. He who used to even test even the machine also. So now is the description given about the country inspector. Let's all please look at. He was a round little man with a red face and a whole box of tools with dials and wires. So that man is always seen carrying a tool kit with him, and he's described as a red face. Children, can any one of you please just guess even why is he called as a red-faced man? Red color indicates anger. So maybe he's a serious-mooded person, maybe. That's the reason Margy calls him as red-faced. And he's a stout man, round in shape, carrying the tools kit. So when this kind of description is given, children, try to please visualize the description of the man given here, so that even, you know, you will find it much more interesting to listen to this story and to listen as well. He smiled at Margy and gave her an apple, then took the teacher apart. Margy had hoped he wouldn't know how to put it together again, and he knew how all right. And after an hour or so, he smiled at Margy. So as soon as she was taken to the country inspector, he smiled at Margy, and what did he do? He gave her an apple. Children, what could be an apple here? Can anyone of you just guess? Is apple a fruit? course not. Apple is, as you all know, it's a company through which many devices of Apple are seen. So in 2157, most of the devices which are electronic devices, they would be of Apple. So here, whatever the word Apple is used, that she was given an Apple by her country inspector, was an electronic device where he would definitely test her IQ levels by using the same device. That's what made her feel much more sorrowful here. But he knew how, all right, and after an hour or so, there it was again, large and black and ugly, with a big screen on which all the lessons were shown and the questions were asked. Now look at the funny way Margie is describing about the computer screen, that is monitor. What is she calling it as? It is large and black and ugly. What could have made Margie say ugly also? Because can a computer monitor be beautiful also? Of course, if you are given a chance to watch your own favorite cartoon film by using your computer monitor, you would find it very beautiful. For example, constantly if somebody asks you only to watch your video lessons of your one particular subject asked together, then maybe probably even you would also find your monitor screen ugly. So what way she is describing her monitor here, she calls it as large, black colored and ugly, which has got all the lessons in that, and always only questions appear, because the computer monitor would expect Margie to give the answers. Because whenever you take any online tests and all, no, you would also see the same kind. The part Margie hated most was the slot where she had to put homework and test papers. Yes, another phase of her difficulty is, once she is given a chance to listen to the whole of the lesson and test is also given, she is left with some sort of homework daily, which she needs to do it and submit. She needs to click on to the submit button. So she used to hate it. And they made her learn when she was 6 years old. So 6 years onwards, she started experiencing the same thing. So children, for today, this is what the content we will end up here. And before I just end up, I tell you all, probably I shall be serving you a worksheet based on the content what I taught you, which you need to comprehend and write down the answers. I guess all of you have definitely found my lesson interesting. So please take some time to read the ebook at home and get ready for the next session. So see you all in the next session, children. This is Vijaya signing off. Thank you.